Over the past few years, I've been able to go out in the winter time working with SnowTrax to CKMP, which is Carl Kuster's mountain park. Now, Carl Kuster is an ex-snowcross racer, which is like motocross on snow. And he was really good in his day at racing, but where his passion lies is in the mountains. Just with my past history with snowcross racing, we were able to hook up over the past few years and go out and ride in the mountains at his facility. He took us to some incredible places. I mean, we were able to see just big mountain scenery in the wintertime. We were able to ride incredibly huge slopes, slay all kinds of jumps and cool little features that you could, you know, launch a sled off of and just have an absolute blast. But at the end of it, in my head, I'm going, what does this place look like in the summertime? I have no idea. So Carl said we should come back. So when we do adventure trips, we always want to take people along that we get along with. And Vern is a guy that I work with, and we've done trips in the past. We have a great time together and have lots of laughs. Wanted to bring him along on this because I knew it was going to be an epic trip.
You know, when AJ had invited me on this trip and I found out that we're going to be going out to the Kelowna area in British Columbia, I was pretty excited because Kelowna and that area of British Columbia is really well known for some of the most spectacular views in all of Western Canada.
One of the coolest things about being out here and heading to CKMP is the drive up. I mean, I've done it in the wintertime and it looks so nice, but I've thought about it in the summer and just sort of thought, like, this is going to be something epic, so I'm excited to do it.
I think so as well. You know, what's going to make it even better is the fact that we're going to be able to take the spiders up from Kelowna to Carl's place. Really looking forward to that part of it.
Yeah, it'll be cool. I had big expectations because Carl has always delivered in the wintertime big fun. I knew that at the end of the day, I would not be disappointed, and at the end of the trip, we were all going to walk away saying this was one of those memorable lifetime experiences. So Carl rides for Ski-Doo in the winter, and Ski-Doo is a BRP brand. So we thought, well, there's lots of different brands under the BRP name, one of them being Spyder. Why not make the trip from Kelowna to Carl's location using the Spyders? I haven't put much seat time in, and BRP was cool with it.
The dealership was great. Banner Recreation inside of Kelowna, they hooked us up with an RT, which is like a luxury touring Spyder, and then also an ST.
I haven't put seat time in on them prior to this for more than just, you know, a couple of minutes here and there, but I knew I wanted to, and I wanted to get a feel for what these vehicles offered. Going from Kelowna to CKMP, there's a couple of routes you can take. One of them is all highway, and we knew on Spyders, we don't want to be all highway. We want to go try some cool stuff. We found this road called West Side Road.
This is a road that meanders alongside of Lake Okanagan for about 75 kilometers. It's a road that you consider more of like a legendary aspect of like a motorcycle touring road. Lots of winding corners, descents, ascents up the hillsides as well. And you get these spectacular views off about a 400-foot cliff.
West Side Road is beautiful. It has these picturesque overlooks that just, you know, show you right down the Okanagan Lake. We were able to zip through the twisties. Vern and I were able to, you know, go from me being leader to him being leader and chase each other a little bit, doing it safely and staying, you know, staggered apart enough.
They're fun. I mean, from a motorcycle standpoint, they're different. They're different from what a motorcycle rider would experience, but nonetheless, it's an altogether different experience that I think everyone needs to try.
You can't just say, hey, I've ridden a motorcycle, I know what a spider's like. And you can't say, hey, I've ridden an ATV or a snowmobile and say, I know what a spider's like. It's kind of a cross between all of those off-road sports wrapped up into one, and yet at the same time, it's super easy to do. $75,000 of tight twisties and really fun scenics was it was a great way to start off a trip. So Can-Am shipped us up quite a bit of product. They sent us a couple of Mavericks and a few of the Outlander L series vehicles, which I'd never ridden before. First day was gonna be all Outlanders. We knew that up on the mountain, there were some tighter trails that we wouldn't be able to get to and access as easily with the Maverick. So we thought, well, let's make day one strictly Outlanders. That'll be kind of cool. CKMP is located just shy of 2 hours north of Kelowna. They're in just an amazing mountain range in the same general area as Mount Revelstoke, which is world renowned.
We start off at 1,000 feet of elevation, and then you can go up to 10,000 feet of elevation. Not very many places in North America, if anywhere, that really have that kind of a swing in elevation and have that many different types of riding.
We started off with some slower riding, and we found this cool little offshoot trail that had trees that had actually fallen down over it, which in the wintertime were probably completely covered by snow and you would never know. We had to kind of like break through some trees and get right off the side of the bikes and duck your head down in the footwell, or you'd scrub your helmet on the trees, and it was pretty cool. I have never ridden a 450 Outlander L. It's a brand new vehicle. I've ridden the 500 V-twin, but I wanted to try this new motor. And I knew that this day we would put it through pretty much everything you can ever see with that vehicle. That little 450 is a stout motor. It's got all you need. And when it's got all you need at 6,300 feet, well, down at sea level, it's gonna be a good ride.
As you sort of got up towards the top, you know, the mountain would start to clear a little bit more, and what you'd get into is more rock. And granite is a pretty common stone out there. And what happens is with all the slides that you get in the wintertime and the general erosion is you get these really, really big slides, rock slides.
There's a few of the spots that are a little bit narrower and probably tougher to get a side-by-side through. From 5 to about 7,300 feet. The trees start to open up as you get closer to the alpine, and then above 73 to 7,500 to 10 is open alpine and glacier.
As we broke through that shale stone, it was like we broke through a barrier of weather as well, because it was a little bit warmer down below. When we started out, it was about 14 degrees. When we got to the shale stone, it was about 10 degrees. And then we broke through. It was like inversion in the wintertime, except the opposite, where it's usually nice up top. It just got cold. Carl said, well, there's a little lake over here. We can stop, we can have something to eat and see if we all warm up, and then we'll go to the peak afterwards. And I kind of had the thought of, you know what? The only thing that's going to keep us warm right now is either the exhaust from these bikes or a fire.
Even though we didn't bring matches, we were able to start a fire. It was pretty humorous in terms of how we did it.
Vern was like, well, we can heat up the exhaust pipe on the bike. And I said, yeah, I brought some Kleenex to clean our goggles. So we just went at it. Vern had the Outlander L450 do about 6,000 RPM.
Oh, she's gonna go.
Yeah. Need a little bit more twigs in there.
I think Carl's got the right idea here. Carl's gonna turbo our fire.
Sure enough, we started up a fire and we got a pretty good one going.
Within probably about 10 minutes, we had this raging fire, roasting hot dogs, eating some lunch, and yeah, it made for a pretty cool experience.
I just have to dust the snow off.
Tune in next week for the remainder of our CKMP adventure, where we'll trek to the top of Mount Quest and then continue our fun in high gear, blasting the mountain logging roads on two of Can-Am's most potent side-by-sides. And finish it all up with some fun on one of British Columbia's most well-known lakes.
If you enjoyed this video, post a comment and let us know what you think. Then, click this link to subscribe and that link for more great videos from DirtTrax TV.